Weirdly, considering how intelligent you have to be to become a self-made billionaire, many of the richest people in the world are really gosh darn stupid with their bank accounts. When one has too much money, there's no telling how much cash one might waste on pointless junk just because one can. If only we had bank accounts that justified some of the crazy purchases we are about to show you. These are the most expensive, useless things billionaires spend their money on. Number 15. Saudi Prince Amir. When you think of expensive cars, you picture a sleek, seamless-looking vehicle driven by Jeremy Clarkson, James May, and Richard Hammond. It has all the bells and whistles, all the speed, and all the looks. But when it has a $4.8 million price tag, you start to wonder if it's not just what's under the hood that adds value, but what's on top of it as well. The world's most expensive car, and a ridiculous purchase by a billionaire, is a mink-furnished Mercedes SL600. It was unveiled at the 50th anniversary of Mercedes-Benz in 2007 and is owned by the Saudi prince Amir al-Waleed bin Talal bin Abdul Aziz. We're only gonna say that once. It's a pretty car when you consider the shape, but it's on a new level when you find out it's diamond encrusted. That's right, from the exhaust to the bumper, the car is covered in 300,000 diamonds. It took 13 experts 2 weeks to attach them. Okay, so the inside is pretty damn impressive too. It's equipped with a V8 and V12 engine and can accelerate from 0 to 60 in just 4.4 seconds. Most people can't even fumble their keys in that amount of time. An everyday person won't be in a hurry to buy a diamond-encrusted car, but it's worth knowing the option is there if you happen to find a spare 4.8 million bucks. Before we go on, we have a cool challenge for y'all. It'll take about 5 seconds to complete. Let's make a deal. Just leave a like on this video, smash that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell, and you will get 10 years of amazing luck and fortune. Try it. It actually works. Now it's time for the odd topic. Dumplings are a light and delicate dish, common in both Chinese and Russian cuisine. They're available for pretty low prices at almost every street food market in the world. But what if we were to tell you that if you added just a splash of Smurf-colored food dye, the price of the humble dumplings would absolutely skyrocket? Blue dumplings are exclusively served at the Golden Gates restaurant in the Bronx, New York, with a mere 16 pieces costing a whopping $4,400. The unique colorization is not actually the result of food dye. One of the ingredients is the addition of courteous flame fish that live in deep water. And this unusual additive gives the dish both its trademark unique color and its insanely sky-high price. Remember to comment down below with the hashtag #oddtopic and let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen. And now, to the next topic. Number 14. Da Vinci Scientific Journal. Bill Gates is a pretty dull billionaire. He wears regular clothing, eats at a particular drive-in in Seattle, and donates a lot of his money to philanthropic causes. As far as wealth goes, he's conservative. But he's not adverse from making a few strange decisions, and the purchase of Leonardo da Vinci's Scientific Journal was one of them. Bill purchased the book, called Codex Leicester, for $30.8 million. That's a pretty expensive price tag for a 72-page book. Within it, the book contains Leonardo's ideas and pictures around architecture, mathematics, botany, mechanics, and astronomy. So why did he buy it? Bill Gates is fascinated by it. Bill believes that Leonardo had an astounding sense of wonder and curiosity, so it makes sense to purchase his thoughts in paper form to see if he can benefit from them himself, then pass on his findings to the world. He also enjoyed Leonardo's insatiable appetite for learning and making life better for others. He would be curious about something, offer his theory, then find out if it were true. It's no wonder Bill wanted a taste of that. Number 13. $2 million gold toilet. Brian Williams, who is more commonly known as the rapper Birdman and co-founder of Cash Money Records, back on my block, nigga, gun up in my hand, loves to flaunt his money, which makes complete sense given what he named his record company. However, he has some strange ideas about what to do with that money. He could, you know, build schools for third world countries, or healthcare centers for those who need them, or even homes for the homeless, but he decided against all that. Instead, he thought, why have a boring old white porcelain toilet? I'm gonna enjoy a literal throne. And he did. Birdman spent $2 million on a gold toilet to feature in his very gold bathroom. He showed off his bathroom to his adoring fans online, and it was a sight to behold. It had shimmery gold wall tiles, gold rubbish bins, and even a gold toilet paper dispenser. It's clear that this rapper doesn't do half measures. However, he might be disappointed to know that even after spending $2 million on a toilet, his bowel movements will still smell like anyone else's. No amount of money can stop a bad burrito from clearing out the main wing of your house. And we all know what they say about rich people and toilets. Number 12, $250,000 shirt made of gold. When you're rich, all practicality goes out the window. If you want to own a gold toilet, you can. And if you want to drive around a car covered in diamonds, no one's gonna stop you. The same rule applies to an Indian money lender and businessman, Dada Fugue, who bought a shirt made entirely from gold in 2013. The custom shirt was worth 12.7 million rupees and weighed over 7 pounds. It's certainly not a shirt you want to go jogging in, that's for sure. It also took 15 artisans over 2 weeks to put on the 14,000 pieces of 22 karat gold. The shirt earned the businessman the title of Gold Man, which is something he adored. Dada said he had always loved gold, even as a child. He always wore gold chains, bracelets, and rings, and people knew him for that. Dada also said he was no different from any other wealthy person who would spend millions of rupees on a Mercedes or Audi. Just 3 years later, Dada was beaten to death by 12 assailants with stones and sharp weapons. It is unknown whether the shirt had anything to do with the murder. Number 11, a shark. Have you ever wanted to own a shark? If you're a billionaire, it'll cost you around $8 million. But before you get grand ideas of buying one to put frickin' laser beams on its head, know that one hedge fund billionaire, Stephen A. Cohen, purchased one dead and was kind of a big deal in the art world. The 14-foot tiger shark was encased in a glass box with a formaldehyde solution, titled The Physical Impossibility of Death in the Mind of Someone Living by artist Damien Hirst. To glance at it, you would think you were viewing a live shark in an aquarium. However, once Steve Cohen purchased it, he replaced the original shark with a 13-foot one, as the original had not been treated with formaldehyde and had begun to decay on the inside. While the artwork shark continued to be on display in the Metropolitan Museum for some years, it may have ended up in Stephen Cohen's home, and we can't help but wonder what that would have been like in the middle of the night. Imagine coming face to face with a 13-foot shark while you head to the fridge half asleep for a glass of milk. We can think of better ways to spend 8 million bucks. Number 10, $3.2 million dog collar. We're a nation of dog lovers, and if you disagree, you can get on out. We buy the best food, treat them with little tidbits when they pull that adorable little pouty face, and even socialize them with other dogs at dedicated dog parks. Some people even like them more than their kids. But if that's not enough for your four-legged friend, then why not do as billionaires are doing and buy them the fanciest dog collar money can buy? No expense was spared in crafting Amour Amour et la Collection des Bijoux Amour piece from I Love Dog Diamonds. The collar has 1,600 hand-set diamonds to the tune of 52 carats and a beautiful chandelier-style centerpiece at the front. There are also 9 pear-shaped diamonds at the front for that extra little bit of elegance on your furry friend. To keep things stylish, the collar itself is a crocodile leather strap for comfort, and it's custom fitted to suit your dog's unique neck. At the end of the day though, your dog is still gonna lick its own bum, regardless of whether it has $3.2 million hanging around its neck. You can't buy class, so you may as well spend your money on something more valuable, like 1.5 million bags of Cheetos or something. Number 9, Mukesh Ambani's home. You would be mistaken for thinking that this 27-story skyscraper in Mumbai is many apartments and home to dozens of families. In reality, it is a single home and one that is owned by billionaire Mukesh Ambani. Why anyone needs a 27-story house is beyond us, but we can only imagine how challenging it is to carry bags of groceries up all those stairs. The house spans 400,000 square feet and costs a whopping $2 billion to build. But once it was built, the costs did not end there. It supposedly takes around 600 people to maintain it, which is sure to amount to a pretty high monthly bill. There are also around 6 stories of underground parking and 3 helicopter pads. The owner, Mukesh Ambani, is an Indian business magnate and the managing director of Fortune 500 company Reliance Industries Limited. He is also the largest shareholder of the company, which is now India's most valuable by market value. Do you know what else Mukesh could have done with that $2 billion? Bought ordinary Indian houses for 1.42 million families in India. Number 8. Roman Abramovich's Super Yacht. Most people would rather be happy and poor than rich and sad. But would you not prefer a cry on your super yacht than in a canoe? Russian-Israeli billionaire Roman Abramovich was pictured leaving his $1.5 billion super yacht after a luxurious Caribbean holiday over Christmas in 2018. But he didn't look altogether happy, and we're not sure why, because look at it. The yacht is a thing of beauty. The super yacht called Eclipse cost around 1.2 billion pounds, which is jump change for the 120th richest person in the world and the owner of Chelsea FC Premier League Football Club. It's 533 feet long and has been in Roman's possession since 2010. It was also the world's largest private yacht until another one called Azam was launched in 2013. It has 24 guest cabins, 2 helicopter pads, hot tubs, a disco hall, 3 launch boats, and a mini submarine. Around 70 people operate the yacht at any given time. Even though the super yacht has such an expensive price tag, it's still not a significant chunk of change for the billionaire. Roman was worth $12.9 billion back in 2019, and that's even after donating more money to charitable causes like schools and hospitals than every other living Russian. Number 7. Ice Cubes. If you drink top shelf spirits as a billionaire, then you may as well enjoy it with top shelf ice cubes as well. Imagine paying $6.50 for a single ice cube. Well, that's what people are doing these days. California company Glace Luxury Ice sells what they call luxury ice cubes for $325. For that $325, you get 50 ice cubes, which are supposed to be of a far superior quality to the ones you buy from your local gas station. They are free of pollutants, minerals, and additives, and come in cube or sphere shape. According to the company, the sphere is one of the most mathematically efficient drink cooling methods. Billionaires who buy these individual ice cubes do get pretty good service when they buy them, though, which can begin to make up for the hefty price tag. They come frozen in dry ice and are packaged in 10 pouches of 5 cubes. They also take up to 40 minutes to melt, which means you can savor your drink for a little longer. Still, for $325, you could buy 325 10-pound bags of ice for the same price, so who's really winning? Number 6. Larry Ellison's Hawaiian Island. American entrepreneur, businessman, and philanthropist Larry Ellison has worked hard to earn his money. He was born in the Bronx and managed to accumulate a net worth of over $67 billion. So when you got that kind of wealth, it's not really surprising that you'd go on holiday and decide to buy the whole place. Kind of like a spin-off plot to Schitt's Creek. When Larry visited Lanai, a remote Hawaiian island, he fell in love. So he put a fat check on the table and called it his. He spent $300 million to gain 98% ownership, which included 90,000 acres of land, 2 Four Seasons resorts, a township with 3,200 people, but note he does not own the people, and some pretty fun things to do. Essentially, Larry can walk around his holiday destination like he owns the show. Because he does. He can go swimming, admiring the koi ponds, horse riding, whatever takes his fancy. He owns all of it, and we think that's pretty spectacular. But do you know what else he could have bought with $300 million? Over 14.6 million 12-piece buckets of KFC chicken. And we're honestly not sure which would be better. Number 5. Flying Palace. Being rich to the average person means being able to buy a fancy car on finance that you'll be paying off for the next 5 years. But for billionaire Saudi Arabian royal Prince Al-Walid bin Talal, I'm not getting tricked into reading that whole name again. It means flipping up couch cushions to find $300 million in loose change for an A380 Airbus airliner. The double-decker jumbo jet remains the largest passenger jet in the world, and it can comfortably cater to around 853 passengers. But when you're a prince, you don't have to travel with that many people, especially if you're gonna be sat in an aisle seat with crying babies around you. No one wants that. So the prince spent another $150 million to turn it into, essentially, a flying palace. It would then transport no more than 100 people, but would be far more luxurious than the average plane. However, before he had the chance to fly it, he sold it to another billionaire who didn't want to wait on a waiting list for the airliner to be built. Number 4. Crystal-covered Lamborghini. Daria Radionova is a 25-year-old entrepreneur from London who spent £350,000 or $456,000 on a Lamborghini Aventador.
I like something shiny.
That's insane, right? But that's not the craziest part. She then spent an unknown sum of money getting the experts at Cars and Cloaks to cover it in crystals. Because, you know, that's what you do when you buy a nice car. You make it shiny. Believe it or not, the Lamborghini is not the first car Daria has had customized with crystals. Before it, she also had three others like it, including a Mercedes CLS, Bentley, and Lamborghini Huracan. While Daria won't let slip just how much the customizing part cost, it's bound to be a fortune. Cars and Cloaks owner Amir said the idea was to complete it in 2 weeks, but only one panel was completed in a single week. It took a lot of hand-eye coordination, late nights, and a lot of pizza, he said. Heartbreakingly, Amir said they even had to start from scratch after crystals didn't line up. The price you pay for a glittery car, right? Number 3. The Sultan of Brunei's Car Collection. If you're gonna be known as the wealthiest monarch in the world, then you better be prepared to do some crazy stuff with your money. The Sultan of Brunei didn't disappoint, for he's the proud owner of 7,000 cars. Most small towns don't even have that many vehicles in them. If you were gonna own 7,000 cars, then sure, buy one of the various models. But that's not Hassan al-Bolkiah's style. Instead, he'll buy one of each color in a model, then purchase multiples of one type for his friends and family. For example, instead of buying one Ferrari 456 GT, he bought 70 of them. He also owns around 80 Bentley Turbo Rs and thousands of other double-ups. The Sultan also has a few favorites, and by a few, we mean a few hundred. He owns over 600 Rolls-Royce, nearly 600 Mercedes-Benz, and hundreds of BMWs as well. What about garaging? Well, we're glad you asked, because 7,000 cars aren't gonna fit in an average two-car suburban home garage, are they? The Sultan has a garage the size of 10 football fields, which means to get to his favorite for the day, it takes around 1.5 hours. He won't want to be in a hurry to get anywhere, that's for sure. Number 2. $3.9 million violin. Music can move the soul, but it can also move the wallet, or so one billionaire found. Russian businessman and lawyer Maxim Viktorov bought a violin at a Sotheby's auction in 2008 for $3.9 million. What was so special about the violin? Was it gold-plated? Was it handcrafted by Jesus? Does it contain hair strands of angels? Nope. Just came from a pretty famous violin maker in Cremona, Italy, who existed during the 17th and 18th centuries. There are now only around 150 violins made by the Guarneris family in existence, hence the high price tag. Instead of locking the violin away in a case, never for it to see the light of day, Maxim put it to good use. He invited 160 privileged people to hear it play for the first time in 70 years at a concert in Moscow. Violin virtuoso Pinchas Zukerman performed Mozart, Bach, and Bruck alongside the orchestra of the Bolshoi Theater. So, what does the world's most expensive violin sound like? Deep. Maxim said its sound is far deeper than other violins. We guess that's a good thing. Number 1. Prince Hans Adam II's fancy furniture. Most people are pretty proud of themselves when they manage to buy a solid wood piece of furniture instead of chipboard with a fake veneer coating. But Prince of Liechtenstein, Hans Adam II, is about to show you how to really buy furniture. This billionaire will shamelessly drop $36 million on a cabinet. 36 million bucks could buy you 364,000 TV cabinets from Kmart, just so you know. Prince Hans Adam II has a personal fortune of around $4 billion and owns the LGT Banking Group.
His family, which is about 900 years old, is the wealthiest royal clan in Europe. So when you're that rich, you can afford to buy pretty things. He has artwork by Rembrandt and Rubens, and significant collections that he has on display in the Liechtenstein Museum. The badminton cabinet he bought for $36 million was also donated to the same museum and remains one of the most expensive pieces of furniture ever sold. It's clear to see that the prince has taste, and you probably won't see him crying into his IKEA instruction manual while trying to assemble a dining set. Do you feel bad for dropping 50 bucks on a giant blow-up flamingo for the pool or a fancy air freshener for your car? Don't, because the billionaires are doing some even crazier stuff. What was the most useless and expensive thing you ever bought? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!